How's it going, everybody? Today we're checking out Signs of the Swarm. M'lady. Sorry. I had to go full Discord mod. I think it's actually Malady, something like that, but I was like, dude, it looks like M'lady. I don't have a fedora, so like, this is the closest I could get, so I guess it's gonna work for now. I have no idea where to put this, by the way. There, we're good. We're solid. So I don't actually know a whole lot about Signs of the Swarm, other than some of their bigger songs. I've listened to probably like at least one track from all their albums, at least from what I can tell. They're good. I don't know if it's really my speed, at least some of their older stuff. I think some of their newer albums gradually got more into my realm of what I listen to a lot more. I'm not really sure what it was. I don't know if maybe it's like the vocal side of things wasn't really my thing. They get really, really heavy from what I can tell, which I like really heavy, but it gets to like the point where it is just full, just muddy, like very like out there. But I don't know. I think I'm starting to come around to that a little bit, so maybe I should go back and check out their older stuff. But yeah, that makes me really excited to check out this new stuff, because from what I've heard, they've been making a lot of changes lately. So yeah, without further ado, let's get right into it. I love their logo too. What? Is just everyone going Thal now?
What?
No. Humanity's last swarm, baby. That should be the title. Oh. Oh, drums. Sounds like he's salivating on the mic. God damn. Thank you, David. Very cool. Getting some fax machine noises. Kind of like a hardcore scream there. A lot more of the clean voice in it. There's that groove, baby. Monstrous, that guitar tone. And there's a bass in there, I think. Sounds like it. Sounds very beefy. Ominous screaming. Oh, we're going Rivers and Nile. We're getting real loud. Okay, we're good. I was gonna say, if it got any louder, I'd have to take my headphones off. Shit. Oh, man. No, the Rivers of Nile references Dreaming Black Clockwork, I think, is off their album The Work. It got really, really loud at the end, and every time I listen to that song, I have to skip the very end, because it literally, like, borderline makes my ears bleed. Rest of the album's really solid, though, but that part, dude. Holy shit, this was sick. I very much enjoyed this. I got some thoughts. So, Signs of the Swarm, Malady, or Malady, I don't know, I like calling it Malady. dude, this song was really, really cool. I know I say that about a lot of songs, but like this, I was not expecting at all. I mean, I had no idea they were gonna go full Thal on us, but I'm here for it, 100%. I mean, to be fair, I'm a little biased, because Thal is like probably my favorite like sub-genre of music. I mean, it's insanely niche. But it's starting to become a little less niche and starting to spread out a little more. I think people are starting to get an idea of what Thal is and kind of reinventing Thal, or just bringing the elements into their music, even, you know, if this song is like a one-off for their next album, which is totally possible. I mean, I'd be fine with that too, but just the fact that they were able to experiment with it, and it's, for me, it was like instantly recognizable. It's so cool. I mean, to me, it just feels like a big homage to these other bands. And especially with the fact that Signs of the Swarm is from the other side of the world, from, you know, a lot of the places where Thal originated, being like Sweden. So, you know, I mean, they're a US-based band, so like for them to bring this out to the deathcore masses and stuff in the US audience as well, I think is a really big deal. But this is really sick. I enjoyed this a lot. The flow of the song was really good. I felt like, you know, even though it was, you know, a heavy song, it had a lot of groove, but like there's times where they let it just kind of, I wouldn't say let it breathe, they didn't go full ambience or anything, but they went into more of like a groove section, and then it was just pummeling you in the face and getting the shit beaten out of you, and they'd stop for a second, get some screaming, go right back in. And it just, I don't know, the pacing to me felt really good. It didn't feel like it was so like claustrophobic, if that makes sense. But this is really, really cool. Like I've said a million times, we'll probably say even more. The vocals, I thought, were really, really enjoyable in this track. That was one of the issues that I had with some of the previous songs, I believe. There's one, it was like Malevolent Enslavement, I think is what it was. It's a good song, don't get me wrong. But for me, it's something that I have a hard time going back to a lot of time, unless I'm in a very specific mood. And I want my ears to get absolutely pummeled by just... which... to be fair, there is a time and a place for that, and I understand. And like I said, it's something where I might have to go back and kind of listen to it a little bit more and make kind of like a reformed opinion on it, because, you know, I kind of listen to this when I look at like my metal journey, is kind of how I look at it. I listened to it at a time where I wasn't listening to that style of deathcore as much, or just metal in general, so I didn't have as much of an appreciation for it. Now I think I've kind of, I don't know if you'd say like gotten used to it, or even like it's an acquired taste. You know, I've been acquired a taste for this style, or well, not even just this style, but like heavier styles as well. Beyond that, it might be something where I go back and actually enjoy it a lot more now. So I don't know, I might eat my own words. But this track in particular, the vocals, like I said, fantastic. And I like how there's like a second vocalist in there who kind of, you know, had his own piece, and it had a little bit more of like a hardcore tinge. It had more of his actual clean, like his vocal cords in there, instead of just, you know, false chords, all that stuff. Once you get into the anatomy, it gets out there. But you hear more of his voice in it, which I thought was really cool. It's a nice touch. And it's only there for like just like a measure or so. So, you know, it wasn't very long. So vocals are fantastic. The guitars were really, really nice. Yeah, I mean, immediately I was like, okay, we're going Thal, boys. I mean, just the chugs, the low tuning, the way that they chugged, and just, I'm not sure if it's something I could explain right off the top of my head, especially off like one listen, but when you know, you know. And then they even have some of the fax machine noises, which isn't just part of Thal. I mean, that's part of stuff like, you know, Djent, which Thal, Djent, they're pretty close, let's be honest. But there are some differences. Thal, Djent, I feel like you hear this a little bit in some of the like hardcore type stuff too. You get some experimentation. I'm thinking stuff like Knock Loose, where they start to get really into like the guitar noises and stuff. But yeah, guitars I thought were fantastic. I believe there was bass in this track. I was trying to pay attention to see if I saw a bass player, because when the guitars are this low, I don't know if it's a bass or not. But from what I heard, the bass was really, really dope. And if that's what I was thinking it was, it did add a lot of depth to just how low it sounded. But, yeah, I thought this track, and before I forget, the drums. The drums were dope. I mean, that's one of the main things. Like, if you don't have solid drums hold down that groove, what are you gonna do? And this track had plenty of that groove, but then they kind of let loose and just beat the shit out of the snare. I love it, you know, right down my alley. Overall, I thought this track was great. The production was really solid. Yeah, but what'd you guys think about this track? Did you like it? Did you not like it? Leave a comment down below. If you have any recommendations, leave that down below as well. As always, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure that like button, subscribe, hit that notification bell. And as always, you guys take it easy.